Hello there, very good morning. You're watching Proactive London and joining us today from Chariot, it's the Chief Financial Officer, Julian Maurice-Williams. Good to see you, Julian. How are you?
Very good, Katie. Great to be here. We've got a busy, exciting and news-heavy period ahead of us. As a reminder to your viewers, Chariot is a transitional energy group focused on Africa and listed on AIM. We have two pillars to our business, transitional gas and transitional power. And both of these pillars are very scalable. Transitional gas is our exciting gas development project called the Anchois development, which sits in the Lixus license just off the coast of Morocco. We've just had a very, very successful drilling campaign. To use a technical term, Katie, we smashed it out of the park. Every reservoir came in that we anticipated and came in above expectations. So we now have a gas project, which is potentially a new gas basin opener, with a basin on the doorstep of Europe, where we all know energy security is becoming increasingly important. Transitional Power is our renewable hybrid developer. We're in a long-term partnership with Total Eren, which is one of the world's leading players within the renewable space. We're focused on the massive power to mining industry within the African continent, and we recently announced the award of our second project, which is a 40 megawatt, so a sizable solar project for a platinum mine in South Africa. In addition, within our power division, we have our green hydrogen project, one of the largest green hydrogen projects in Africa, and that's in Mauritania. There, we're looking to produce green hydrogen from electrolysis or splitting of water using electricity generated from solar and wind. So this is a management team, Katie, who took over just over 18 months ago. We've done exactly what we said we would do, and we will continue to do exactly what we said we will do. And we've backed ourselves with millions of dollars of our own money. And our laser-guided focus for the next period ahead is to get to those cash flows, both from the gas and the power, as quickly as possible, and get that cash into the pockets of our shareholders.
Right. I love all this confidence. Brilliant, Julian. So maybe tell us about your gas project, if you would.
Absolutely, Katie. So transitional gas, as I said, is the Anchois development project. It sits in the Lixus license, which is just on the Atlantic coast of Morocco, just south of Spain, and very close to the major international gas pipeline that goes from Africa up into Europe. And what that means is we can look to supply gas, not just into the growing Moroccan energy market, but also potentially into the very, very lucrative European gas market as well. As I said previously, we just completed our very successful drilling campaign. We carried that out safely, on time and on budget, which shows that Chariot is a team that excels at carrying out these large offshore development projects. The main well within that drilling campaign was the Anchois 2 well, where we went through over 100 meters of net gas pay, multiple reservoirs. And from that well, we've taken numerous gas samples, numerous sidewall cores of the well, as well as lots of other significant well data. It's also worth noting that from that campaign, we now have two potential producer wells, Anchois 1 and Anchois 2. And what this does is not only does it fast track that development, meaning that we get those cash flows potentially quicker, but also it means that the CapEx spend on that development will be reduced by the amount of those two wells. Now, to give your viewers an idea of the size of the prize around our gas development project, our NPV10 to Chariot, based on the 2C contingent resources of 361 BCF, it was around $500 million. Now, to be clear, that was the pre-drill NPV10, and we're working on new figures at the moment. We expect that figure to go up significantly based on the additional gas that we discovered in the recent drilling. Now, the development itself of the project is a simple and standard development. It's been done in lots of other places. And we're working very closely with Subsea Integration Alliance, which is one of the world's leading developers of projects like this. And we have a collaboration agreement with them. We're also working with a very large multinational investment bank looking to debt finance this project. For gas offtake, we announced towards the end of the last year that we had agreed key terms with a major international energy group to take 40 million scf a day for up to 20 years on a take or pay basis. And what this offtake key terms means that actually can help to debt fund and underpin the core development, then allowing us to sell excess gas either into the Moroccan market or potentially the European market as well. And with the same international energy group, we're also looking potentially at partnering, possibly along the value chain, and we'll look to announce something on that as and when we can. So our focus as a management team is to get to those material cash flows from the gas project, but also to ensure that we maintain as much of this project that we can. And we're going to be very smart about how we finance it.
All right, well, let's talk about the news of the day, the Rissana offshore license there and what it means. So tell us about this new license signature.
Yeah, absolutely, Katie. So Rissana offshore, it's a new license. We previously announced that we had agreed the key terms of this license. We've now formally signed all the license documentation. This license goes around the outside, the offshore area of the Lixis license, which contains the significant gas discoveries that I just spoke about. It's a massive area, Katie. It's almost half the size of Wales, several times the size of the Lixis license. And picking up this license is really up about capturing potential running room. So by running room, I mean prospective low risk gas resources, similar to discoveries that we've had within the Lixis license. And we've done all this for a very low 2D seismic commitment, which will cost $1 million or so. But what's really exciting is Chariot and our investors don't have to wait for that 2D seismic campaign to be carried out, because we already have large swathes of 3D seismic across the block. This is excellent quality 3D seismic data from historic campaigns. And the Chariot team are already working on this data and looking for seismic attributes which are similar to the discovery within the Antoine development, which would be extremely low risk.
All right. And finally, in conclusion to this, why should they feel enthusiastic now about Chariot?
I think for two reasons, Katie. First of all, this business is now significantly de-risked, both within the gas and the power, and we're now heading towards those material cash flows. Secondly, we've got a busy period ahead of us, lots of news, lots of triggers. Within transitional power, we'll have announcements on partnering, we'll have announcements on gas sales and other commercialization, all heading towards those material cash flows. On transitional power, we'll have the pipeline of further renewable projects coming through. We'll have potential partnering on our green hydrogen project, as well as strategic partnering at the transitional power level, which will provide further finance to progress these projects further. So as I've said many times before, Katie, we want to be an exciting, different, busy stock. We're going to get out there, we're going to do stuff, we're going to bang the drum, and we're going to make sure that our shareholders get the value in the share price that they deserve.
All right, Julian, thank you very much indeed from Chariot here on Proactive London this morning.
Thank you.